26-40, units respond on fire ground 1. Engine 29, engine 45, engine 52, you're the writ. Engine 20, engine 44, truck 25, truck 16, battalion chief 5, battalion chief 3, safety officer 4, respond 5210 Linden Heights Avenue. Between West Belvedere Avenue and the dead end, report of dwelling fire. Approximately 46-40, units respond on fire ground 1. Engine 29, engine 45, engine 52, you're the writ. Engine 20, engine 44, truck 25, truck 16, battalion chief 5, battalion chief 3, safety officer 4, respond 5210, Linden Heights Avenue between West Belvedere Avenue and the dead end. Report of the dwelling fire, operations fire ground 1, your time out 1542.
25.
Engine 46 on AC dispatch, which rolls 5 rounds.
Engine 46 on Rice Attorney Drew Paul Drive. Can you put me on that 46 box?
Battalion 5 to the unit calling. What's your message?
Engine 46 on Rice Attorney Drew Paul Drive. Can you put me on that box?
Engine 46, that's affirmative. Take the box.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm on Rogers and Wabash. Is in that box?
What was the unit?
1240.
That's affirmative. Take the box.
Engine responding on box 146-40, also receiving 5208 Reisterstown. Safety officer 4, 1543.
Flying.
Give it time, Chief 2. 1544.
Engine 29, two stories middle of the group, fire showing on the rear, you make me command.
Here's on max alarm 46-40, squad 40 on scene, reporting two story middle of the group, fire showing from the rear, squad 40 Linden Heights Avenue command, timer started 1545.
Time 5 on the scene. I'll give you an update in a minute, but you go ahead and make us a working fire. Units are going to stage on Belvedere and Linden Heights.
Right, G5, message received. Working fire, staging Belvedere and Linden Heights, 1545.
522 to communications.
Is that 5E22?
Yeah, we're going to be clear of this T5 box. Put me on that 46 box. You can add FIB 12 and FIB 14.
And Linden Heights Avenue for the dwelling stage at Belvedere and Linden Heights. Staging area is Belvedere and Linden Heights. Operations Fire Ground 1. Your timeout is 1547.
Battalion 5, I'm on command post on the Alpha side. Two story, fourth front. Second from the end of the group, we got a heavy fire in the rear with extension. Right to the address is going to be 5210 Linden Heights.
Command, we just cleared a medic run. We're on garrison. Question the pink box.
Yeah, take it. When you get here, when you arrive, I need you to get in 5212.
12, I copy. Going to 5212.
First, right now, I don't have a truck on the scene.
44, I'm covering 45, Slug.
40, formations. Sir, police. Belvedere, all lanes, heavy traffic.
Command and copy. Please notify 1548.
For you. Stand by 1 second.
Exterior fire. Stop it from walking the block.
Copy.
Well, 4629 is in the second from the end. I want you to stop it at the third from the end.
Copy. 46. Close my line.
Truck 25 command. We have no access to the front.
46, mayday, mayday, mayday. Command all units, mayday's been declared. Unit calling the mayday, go ahead.
46, you need to line up to it. 229, mayday, 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 first floor.
command communications. I need you to dispatch a brick task force. A mayday's been declared. Stand all units. Emergent traffic only on the radio.
Here's the box line 46-40. Mayday, mayday, mayday. Engine 29, portable 1, first floor.
29. I need you to give me a report on your location.
OM2, place near Route 5.
Command Battalion 23 Charlie Division, I need you to get 46 to start dumping it in from the rear.
Battalion 3 Cox, we have heavy fire on 3 dwellings. We're starting to put some order on it now. Do you have the location of the mayday?
Command Communications, I need a second alarm.
Command copy.
Done, I need a report.
Front door, mayday. At the front of the door. We need a storm. Your car is out the window. Our car is out the window. Mayday.
Okay, 29. Can you get out of the dwelling? Are all your people accounted for?
46. More pressure on the line.
Charlie Division, we only have one line in the back. We're going to need at least two more.
Okay, Charlie Division, I got units coming on the second alarm. Just start grabbing them and use them as you get them back there.
Okay, copy that. Do you have a location for the members on the mayday?
Reporting first floor. We're trying to knock the fire on the first floor now.
Fuck, well, I got the fires off the window. I got members down certain side.
Copy, we're just waiting for members to get back. Put us on it. We'll be in around.
Okay, I have it on fire ground one.
Thank you.
Last 40. Operation fire ground one. Battalion Chief 2, EMS 5, PIO respond, 5210, Linden Heights Avenue for the second alarm of fire. Mayday declared. Timeout is 1552.
Engine 44 in the rear. Engine 20, charge line.
Engine 46, mobile to 44, mobile, charge that hydrant.
Command to all units responding. I want you to focus your attention on the exposures.
46, mobile, more pressure.
46, mobile, stand by. I'll wait for the hydrant to be charged. I'm out of water.
Man, the 56, you're going to be the rescue crew supervisor. I need a report on any members of 29 that you removed from the building.
I called the command. I'm a down member. Just inside the front door. I need an engine company to keep flowing water. We're trying to estimate them now.
Okay, do you have a count for both the pipe man and the officer?
44. So 20 mobile, charge the line.
Engine 45, PO, charge our line, charge it, alleyway.
46, charge your 5, side.
Call 5 to command, place the suppression units on another channel.
Command to squad 40, you're coming in cargo, I need a report.
Well, what's the plan?
Got both members of Engine 29. Okay, I copy. Command all units. We're going to remain on this channel. I need a PAR. I need an accountability report. Italian Tech 5 is going to do a PAR. Command communication, I need 2 additional medic units. I need them to report to the front.
Command, 2 additional medics, 1555.
Battalion Chief 3 Tech, come to the rear of the building.
We have 0 water. We need water.
46 move, I'm working on it. Everybody's charged the plugs. I gotta run there and charge it.
Copy. Engine 45 1 to 45 mobile. Charge that alley line.
45 engine portable 4 to portable 2. You want water?
Command to truck 12. I'm going to make you the rescue crew supervisor.
I need a report on whether we got all the members of Engine 29.
Engine 46, charge every line you got coming off your wagon. Engine 45, charge your line.
Emergency command. Myself, the officer from truck 15 has a line. We're making entry out the side to the front door. Have companies in the rear. Dump all of our A guys. We're encountering high heat rate at the front door. Still trying to get a good search.
Okay, I copy. Are we still missing someone from Engine 29?
I don't know. No one's giving me a straight answer on that yet.
Charlie Division, to the first engine on the second alarm. I need you to find a hydrant, come to the side, Charlie, with your 2.5 and your mini bliss.
Command all units, emergency radio traffic only. I have accounted for all four members of Engine 29. Need to do a par for the rest of the fire ground. Communications, make the announcement we're going to do a par.
Command copy, 1557. Car 5 on the scene, 1557. All units on fire, 46-40, 925, conducting a par, 1557.
Engine 20 to engine 29, I'm covering your hydrant.
Tank GPMS, respond. On the second alarm, Firefighter 46-40, operating high ground 1, 5210 Linden Heights Avenue, between West Belvedere Avenue and the dead end. Operations Fire Ground 1. Battalion Chief EMS responded on the second alarm of fire by 46-40, 5210 Linden Heights Avenue between West Belvedere Avenue and the dead end. Mayday declared. Timeout of 1558.
Engine 45's par. Side Charlie. Fuel that wagon.
Engine 20. Par.
Flying par. Three members on Alpha, one member on the Papa.
Engine 44 par.
44 par, PO out wagon, LA, V off that wagon.
Truck 25 par.
8, hold off on just the one section and charge it.
Truck 25 par, side Alpha.
Truck 16 par.
16. 401, in the doorway, side Alpha. Got a move by the truck in the rear. 403 and 4, I don't have that yet.
Truck 12, par.
Truck 12, 401. I'm on the front porch. Gonna have to call portables 2, 3, and 4 and get their locations.
Truck 12, portable 2, I'm in the Charlie side, Delta.
Truck 12, portable 3 and 4, par.
Truck 12, portable 1. I can see portable 4. He's in the front, he's in the street. Call portable 3. It's a member of 146.
Copy.
Charlie Division, we need BG electric side emergency response. We have multiple wires arcing back here.
Command, copy that. Communication, give me BG. Truck 12, portable 3. I need a report from you.
Command communications, par has been conducted first alarm units. All units are par.
Thank you, 5. Message received. All units par, 1601.
I'm Captain Moore Taylor in Sky Team 11, presently in the area of Reicherstown Road and Belvedere Avenue. Fire department's fighting a two-alarm fire at this location. They have at least four homes that are totally involved in flames here. The fire department just put out a mayday call for a fire official or fire personnel that was trapped on the first floor of one of the dwellings that was on fire. I think they've been able to rescue him at the present time, but expect major delays. They've shut down Belvedere both directions at Reicherstown Road, and there's more units coming to this fire. We're still trying to get more information. As we do, we'll update you reporting to Sky Team 11. I'm Captain Roy Taylor.
I call to command. He's still to use his second line out the five front porch. Original fire building.
On the end, on the rear.
Okay, I copy.
Charlie Division. The second is going to be the original fire building. The third is going to be the Bravo exposure. Correction, Delta exposure. Command to all units to operate the Delta exposure. Evacuate the building.
Since there's emergency traffic on fire ground channel, I'm at Linden and Belvedere.
Linden and Belvedere.
Evacuate the building. All units on the Delta exposure, evacuate the building. 1603.
Station at 46. Acknowledge the way to 1603.
EMS 5, command. I'm going to commit myself with medic 11.
Command to Charlie Division. Got the truck back there, Matt?
That's affirmative. I have 16 and 12 back here.
Okay, I copy. Command to truck 12, portable 1. You're relieved of your rescue group supervisor duties. I need a report on where you're at and what you're doing.
I call the command. Myself, portable 4, truck 16, portable 1, we're on the front court, side alpha, original fire building, flowing water in from the outside.
Okay, I copy.
Car 5, command, we need BG&E electric side emergency response in the rear. In car 5,
BG&E. Okay, the request.
Communication command.
Portable 2 to portable 1. What's your location?
Charlie Division, 46. Another section to the 5 side.
Okay, so we all seen of the 46 box.
Message received, car 2, 1605.
Hey, 2 on scene, 1605.
5th officer, 4 on the scene, assuming safety.
Yeah, officer, 4, 1605.
OEM
2 on scene. OEM 2 on scene.
Exposure, Delta 1.
Copy, shut it down.
43 is covering the hydrant of who's ever at Linden Heights and Belvedere.
Truck 16, portable 1. It's a portable 3 and 4. What's the location?
Engine 45. Inside Charlie. There, drop these electric wires down on the fences. Members, refrain from touching any fencing or any metal.
Truck 5, command. 5214, this stable of agent. We do need a line inside on the second floor.
Okay, that's obvious. Anything you can send in to, it would be the Delta 1 with a line for the rear.
Truck 5, command. We have a line in the Delta 1. It's in the front. We were able to knock down the first floor. Looks like everything else might be on the second. It's pretty strictly sound at the moment.
Charlie Division, all members operating on a roof, do not step on any of these exposures. Been on fire. They're all in really bad shape.
At Linden Heights, switching over to Fire Round 1.
1609.
Detain GPMS, I'm on scene, assuming EMS branch, Medic 11, just went route to 634, priority 1, firefighter.
If you need to, grab another channel.
Copy. Command, do we have one additional patient?
Right now we had the 2. There's a third member of 29 engine, I want to get checked out.
Copy.
You can go ahead and set up the resource for rehab.
Copy, all advised.
46 mobile to 44, portable 1. You ready for water? 2 lines have been added.
Go ahead.
8 mobile to 81. You guys ready for that blitz line? That monitor to be charged?
44 to 81. Go ahead for charge monitor.
Command all units. We're going to put the deck gun for 29 in the front window of the original fire building. So if you're operating hose lines, you might lose pressure.
Talk 2 on scene.
Talk 2, 1611.
It's Linden Heights Avenue. Linden Heights Avenue is where this fire is. Right there north of Belvedere, just to the east of Reicherstown Road. When fire crews got here, they had heavy fire showing from 2 of the dwellings. It quickly sped to a third dwelling. We now have 4 dwellings that are involved here fully involved in flames. We heard a mayday call come out with a firefighter that was evidently trapped on the first floor. I don't know if the floor gave way or what. They ended up rescuing that firefighter. We do not know if injuries reference that rescue, and it appears now that the fire is moving to a fifth home here on Linden Heights Avenue. We're still trying to get more information on this fire, how it started. We don't know about injuries at the present time. We do know some of the dwellings were occupied as far as this fire goes. So right now, expect major delays on Belvedere. They have shut it down both east and westbound. Fire equipment is still responding to the scene here since it went to two alarms. And we'll monitor the situation and update you as we can. Reporting live in Sky Team 11, I'm Captain Roy Taylor.
Firefighters, Secondary 210 and 634, or the Burn Center.
634 is Medic 11, and Medic 10 is at 634.
Copy, both. Transport 634.
Heavy smoke coming from the end of the group and the one next to it. We have a portable monitor in service and five hand lines.
Okay, I copy. Yeah, we still got fire in the end of the group and the original fire building. We're gonna put a mobile monitor in service out front here. And the 2nd Battalion, you're gonna be Bravo Division.
I copy. Truck 16, portable 1 to portable 2. What's your location? 16 up there.
Truck 16, portable 2. I'm inside 5216.
Copy. You got AJ with you?
Negative. I was portable 4.
Portable 3. I'm not sure what you're saying.
Copy.
That's you on the command. 5216. You didn't have any extensions. Just some trap smoke. And they're heading to 5214 and hunting the seals on the second floor.
Okay, I copy. 5216 is what you're reporting. Check the third floor. Check the Bravo wall, the Bravo party wall. It looks like it's a firewall, but it looks like there's extension into the roof area. Just go up and open up and make sure we didn't get nothing in.
All right, I copy.
Palmer County Paramedic 3.
Palmer County Paramedic 3, 1614.
Charlie, engine 21, come down here. I want you to get a 2.5 off engine 45. Drag it around to the Charlie side and place the portable monitor in service.
Alarm units operating on the fire ground, not the rapid intervention task force units.
Okay, it's going to be truck 8, engine 30, truck 1, EMS 5, PIO, engine 43.
Thank you.
You're welcome, 1615.
Command, the rescue line, what's your report again?
Scene has a light smoke condition right now. Do you think it's extending Alpha or Charlie?
It's on that Delta wall in the roof area, if it's anywhere.
Copy, we're not seeing anything at this time.
Command to the roof. Can you give me a report?
20 to 29, how's your pressure? I can pump you if you need me.
Good right now.
We're hooked up, let me know. Truck 25 to command. Everything is opened up until 2018, and we have a line up here in service.
Okay, I copy. It's rolling pretty good in 5214, which will be four swelling in, and you just make sure there's no extension for the top wall facing the
16. Truck 16, portable 2 to command. I'm in 5216. That would be the exposure Delta 1, we're open up and we got nothing.
Okay, I cop.
Engine 45, Charlie, this is engine 21 already has a blitz with a ram gun in the rear already, but no water. We're going to relay water into them. Is that okay?
Command to 45, repeat your message.
Engine 21 already has a 2.5 blitz line laid with a monitor pipe in the rear, but they don't have water. We're going to relay water into them. Is that okay?
It's affirmative. Go ahead and do that.
Okay. 21, transfer to the station of truck 25. Truck 21, transfer to the station of truck 25. Now, 82 is 1618.
Okay, I copy.
Charlie Division, truck 16 reports. There's no extension into that fish dwelling. We were up there. They're pulling some sealants just to double check.
Okay, I copy.
Yeah, rescue one in command. We got the ceiling pulled in 5216, right along the wall between 5214 and 5216. We don't have any extension here, just some trap smoke.
Okay, I copy. Rescue one. Rescue one, you're going to be in the Delta Division. I just need to keep an eye on those adjacent dwellings. Make sure there's no extension. Need to know who's operating. You can call Battalion Tech 5 or 3.
Copy, Delta Exposure. I think it's down to the 5214, and that's about it.
52 to 21, too. Let me know when you're ready for your water.
21, let it flow.
Command and communications and all units operating on the fire ground. We're going to conduct the second part. This will include units on the second alarm and the Brit Task Force.
Tech 5, engine 46, FAR.
260, portable 3, come out the side, Charlie.
2, FAR.
52.
Tech 5 to 52, FAR.
45, 2 inside, Charlie, 2 at the bumper.
416, FAR, side, Charlie, all 4 members.
Rescue 1, FAR.
Rescue on one member, 5214, other three members out on the front in front of 5212 and 5214.
Engine 44, FAR.
44, FAR, portable 2, at the pumper.
Truck 25, FAR.
Truck 25, FAR, roof.
Engine 13, FAR. Engine 13, FAR. One member of the wagon, 3 in Delta 1. Engine 8, FAR.
Engine 8, FAR. 3 members, side Charlie, Bravo Exposure, 1 at the pump panel.
Engine 30, FAR.
Pump.
Engine 30, FAR. Side Alpha.
Truck 8, FAR.
Truck 8, FAR. Side Charlie.
Truck 1, FAR.
Truck 1, FAR, all 4 members, roof division.
Truck 5, FAR.
Truck 5, all 4 members, FAR. Side Alpha, Delta, Delta 1, exposure. Exposure.
Fly 26, FAR.
Charlie Division, man, I just made face-to-face with PGE. They're going to shut down half this block.
Man, I'm direct.
4-4.
Engine 4-4, side Bravo, 4 members.
43-4.
Engine 43-4, 3 members of side Alpha, 1 member at the pumper.
Tech 5 to command. Par is completed. All units accounted for.
I'll be engine 29. I got 3 that were transported to the hospital. I got the PO right here. Man, update. We had fire originally in 5210. We had extension in the 5208, 5212, 5214. It looks like that's where we stopped at. We still have numerous hot spots throughout. We're still working on fire.
Yeah, copy. 1627.
Delta to command. In the Delta exposure 5212, engine 13 has a hand light on the front porch roof. There's a lot of fire burning towards the middle of the building. You got anybody in the rear? Do you want to let us go in the second floor? Roof division to company operate on Delta side. Keep that line down. You're hitting us on the roof.
Squad 40.
Or if you want to let us go in through the second floor window off the floor, so we can get a knock on it.
Just knock it from the exterior if you can. They got nines operating in the rear. Command Charlie Division, the Delta exposure, you got nines going in the rear of that water anyway.
Truck 5, Command. We're breaching the wall in the Delta water, so Delta exposure now, second floor.
Okay, I cop. Do you have any fire conditions in the Delta 1?
To the Command, there was fire conditions in Delta 1, 5214. It's all been extinguished. A couple hot spots. Like truck 5 said, we're going to poke a hole in this wall between 14 and 12 and try to get to that fire in the middle of the building.
Okay, I got
truck 7 portable too. Come back to the house, sorry, please.
It's been shut off from the pole.
Man, copy. Locations, Battalion Chief EMS.
Battalion Chief EMS.
He's lateral with Command.
Copy. I'll go do a face-to-face.
Copy. 1630.
Command of Route Division. Can you just do a structural integrity check on all those roofs? I know you told me the Delta's in bad shape, but could you just make sure the other ones are safe to operate on?
14 and 16, okay. We're on 14 now, trying to make some holes at 12. 12 to the end is a no-go.
Command of Route Division, you copy?
I copy, Chief. Did you copy my message?
Saying 12 is the only one that's not safe to be on, correct?
12, 10, all the way down that way. 14 to 16 are okay, but I'm limiting how many I put on here.
Take Alpha 3 to BCMS. Where's your location?
Our 414 to communications.
414.
We're responding to the second alarm. Could you tell me if they have rehab set up and where?
I just spoke to the 5-1 operator. He's advising that they didn't set up a rehab service.
Car 414 copy, switching to 5-1.
Message received, 1635.
21 cop.
Command to, Robins. How's fire conditions looking at, Linden Heights?
Okay, G6, we're on location on Linden Heights.
G1639. Okay,
15.
425. Looks like one member truck 10, two members of truck 16 up here.
In Bravo, you still have some fire rolling on the second floor fin on the Charlie side in the middle room. We have, on the original fire building, we have a lot of fire knocked, visible fire. We're hitting some high spots. On Delta 1, or the Delta exposure, we're hitting some high spots. And Delta 1 looks pretty good at this time.
Man, I got Command communication. Just confirming you made the announcement that the Mayday was cleared.
Negative now. Hey, Houston, all units, box alarm 46-40. Command, Mayday has been cleared. Mayday has been cleared. 1641.
Bravo Division. Conditions are improved over here. We still do have fire, though, in the roof line leading in the center of the building.
Truck 16, Command.
I don't think you ever filled out my second alarm. Can you fill out the second alarm so I can attack the reserve?
Command, cop, 1644.
Command to any unit operating the hose line that's not currently using it. Can you report that to Command? I need a line on the Bravo exposure to be the engine group. Command to Charlie, can you get a line down there to the Bravo exposure? Command to Charlie, disregard.
EMS branch Command requesting one additional medic unit and additional EMS officer.
Thank you.
Truck 8, engine 30, truck 1, tank 2, EMS 5, PIO, engine 43.
Medic 17 to command.
EMS branch to command. I'm requesting one additional medic unit, one additional EMS officer.
I copy. Command communication. Fill that request for EMS branch. And then dispatch the two additional engines for standby.
Command, I copy. Two additional engines, standby, special call, one additional medic, one additional EMS officer, 1647.
Medic 17 to dispatch, what channel is EMS branch on?
Communications to BCMS.
Go ahead.
Supervisor, EMS branch channel.
EMS 3, respond. On the second alarm of Firefox 46-40, Operations Fire Ground 1, 5210 Linden Heights Avenue, between Wells and Bedwell Avenue and the dead end. EMS 3 respond on the second alarm of Firefox 46-40, 5210 Linden Heights Avenue, between Wells and Bedwell Avenue and the dead end. You're talking about a 1640.
Engine 45, portable 1, engine 45 mobile. You can give me about 10 more up on that hour line.
Affirmative.
Communication to command.
Command, Scott.
Command, your additional engines to standby, engine 5, engine 36. Also be advised, you'll have MO 23, EMS 3, EMS division.
Yeah, cop.
1649.
Firefighter roof command.
Roof division, guys.
Have the members on the roof stop throwing bricks.
Stop.
Engine 5 on the
FIB 11, FIB 22.
Engine 5, verify your response.
Engine 36 to command, we're about 2 minutes out. Did you say personnel to the command post? Copy that.
Charlie Division, Roof Division. Which member's up there without his headgear? Put his helmet on.
I got him.
Howard County, Engine 11, Baltimore City Dispatch. Run route to your squad 40 station on Liberty Heights Avenue.
Okay, Howard County. 1654.
Car 414 is on the scene, located alongside Medic 18 on Belvedere Avenue.
Car 414, 1654.
Right, Medic 18.
Copy. Communications ENS 3, MO 23. You copy?
MO 23, copy. Park at Belvedere.
ENS 3 is correct.
Units copy, 1655.
Battalion Chief 1, 1st and a quarter of Engine 6, Battalion Chief 1, 1st and a quarter of Engine 6, Old Town, time is 1656.
Copy that. My rehab unit is inbound. As soon as they get here and get set up, I'll start pulling them through.
Command update. We're still working on hot spots in the four dwellings I previously said that had the original fire building plus the extension to the Bravo, to Delta, and the Delta 1. Units are still operating from the exterior and trying to chase hot spots.
Command updates received, 1657.
Truck 10, portable. When you have a minute, come to the truck.
Truck 10, portable 2, copy.
Division command, I'm sending truck 25. The member from truck 16, the member from truck 10 down. I'm going to keep myself and truck 5 screw up here. Roof division to the engine company on Bravo side. Now realign, you're overshooting the building, it's not.
We're doing the best we can. We gotta hit the roof line.
We got a line up here for that.
You hit that chimney from the top side.
Head.
Set a line up there.
That's correct. We're putting water on the heavily down, deep burn through. We're trying to keep it down so we don't shoot over.
Okay, we'll keep it down and move out of the way if you can hit it from up there. We're blocked by two.
Yeah, we got a shot at it right now. We're putting water on it.
Copy.
Well, we know we have at least five homes that are damaged, four of them significantly. The fifth one, it just appears that the roof had caught fire. But firefighters have been trying to make an aggressive attack here. Now, we have video to show you of what it looked like when the firefighters first arrived here at the scene. They had heavy flames coming from three dwellings, and they quickly sped to a fourth dwelling here on Linden Heights Avenue, which is right near Righteoustown Road and West Belvedere Avenue. We know three firefighters were injured. Two of them actually called a mayday call. I know one ended up going to the hospital. I don't know his condition. I know they're still checking out the other two. We're still trying to get more information on that. But the problem dealing with right now, West Belvedere Avenue is shut down both directions. Righteoustown Road is shut down north of Belvedere. They have an issue with the power lines. We've been watching them arcing. They've actually requested BGE to respond to the scene here to assist with that. Some of the power lines have actually fallen down and are touching the fences in the area. So the fire department's really concerned about that. They're still fighting this fire. They're trying to keep it from spreading. We don't have a cause, but we can tell you a couple of the roofs have actually collapsed at this location on this fire. We'll get more on it as we do. We'll update you reporting live in Sky Team 11. I'm Captain Roy Taylor.
Down and get water to the rear where front 12 is. If you want to have 5 engines come here and pump the plug, that would probably be necessary. It's only a 6-inch main.
Engine 45 portable 1 and engine 45 mobile. Go ahead and charge that alley line back up.
45 copies of water coming.
EMS branch to come in. You can make EMS 3 rehab group. It's going to start calling down the first alarm company.
Okay. Command all units on the fire ground. We're going to start doing rehab. When they call you to rehab, I need to know where you are and what your assignment is. If you can't go, just call the bypass and we'll get to you.
EMS branch, all units be advised. Rehab is going to be set up at Belvedere and Righteoustown.
25. Can I report for rehab?
Charlie's visit.
2-4. Go ahead and charge us.
You 45. Yes, you are. Just done.
36, copy. Rehab engine 52. Can you report to rehab?
Engine 52.
Side out.
We're on a force roof.
Rehab engine 52. You're committed, correct?
Correct.
Engine 20, are you able to report to rehab?
20, affirm.
Where's that 400, whatever you want.
It's on the way.
Roof division, the truck's off tip. Put your gloves on.
Come in, OEM.
Howard County Engine 141, communications.
Howard County 141.
We're on the transfer to 13 engine. Just got radio range. We'll let you know when we're close enough to run.
1715.
Rehab engine 44. Be able to refer to rehab.
Standby, I'll check
the rehab copy. Rehab to truck 16. Are you able to report to rehab?
44, coming to rehab.
Rehab copy.
Roof division to come in.
Roof division, go ahead.
The end house, I'm not sure what the number is. It's through the roof in the middle. Best access to try to put some water on. It's going to be taking a line up 12 trucks tip and raise that up over it.
Okay, I cop. Come in, truck 12. Do you have water to your ladder pipe?
No, we haven't set up the ladder pipe yet. I have a member at the tip of the ladder working the roof to try to get it open a little more.
Command to the members operating on the original fire building porch roof. You got too many people up there. Get off the roof. Command to 36. I want two of your members up there and everybody else can get off.
Copy.
Bravo Division in command. We're going to stretch a hand line from 12 truck ladder. It's about all we get to fly right now.
Okay, I copy. Command to 36. Just get everybody off of those porch roofs. If you want, you can operate the line from that ladder, but I want you all off the porch roof.
Charlie Division, all members operating on the Charlie side. If you have not done so and you're not actively operating a hand line, change your bottle out.
Man, truck 16, portable one, off the roof. Man, truck 12, let me know when you get that line up there and what kind of progress you make.
And off the roof.
EMS Ranger Command, I'm going to release Baltimore County Medic 3 and replace them with City Medic 27.
Command, I copy.
Truck 10.
Are you able to report the rehab?
On our way.
Copy.
Car 5, engine 4, portable 1.
Engine 4, go ahead.
Have that ladder pipe drop down a little bit so it's below the windowsill and have them try to bounce it off the seal and cool the rest of that room off.
Engine 50, transfer to the station of engine 29. Engine 50, transfer to the station of engine 29, time now 1743.
Car 5 to Charlie.
Charlie, go ahead.
Enough lines falling from the rear. We're going to shut down this ladder pipe.
You want me to shut down the lines in the rear?
Negative. We want to keep it flowing while we move that ladder pipe.
Yeah, I've got five of them in service.
Engine Bixby, we acknowledge the transfer to 29 engine.
1746.
Rehab group to truck 12. You report to rehab.
Truck 12, I copy. I'm going to need a company to relieve me of the turntable.
Come in, truck 12, portable 1.
Truck 12, go ahead.
Are you available to come to the front of the building? If not, just let me know.
Yes, sir, on my way.
Rehab group to engine 46. Can you report to rehab?
Bravo Division to Charlie. We're going to swing that ladder around through the rear and vision that up over window.
36, shut your lines down.
FIV 14 to car 5.
Command post engine 52, report to rehab.
Car 5, FIV 14.
Yeah, Chief, I don't know if you're still looking for the person about the post. I'm with that person right now on side Bravo, right next to truck 16.
Okay, I'm coming down. Command post engine 46, report to rehab, acknowledge.
46, acknowledge.
FIV 14 to car 5. I'm in the auto body parking lot to the left of the fire ground.
Man to DC 2, DC 3, and battalion 6. Report to the front of the building.
DC 2, copy. Battalion Tech 2, report to the front. You need it from your angle.
Hey, yeah, we're trying to. We're waiting for truck 12 to be able to reposition their aerial, see if we can hit it from the top. Looks like it's burning above the roof line inside.
Front of the building in the corner lot, the vacant lot.
FIV 12 command, we're doing a briefing with the ATF and police
You need me right this second?
That is correct. We know one has been transported. We just saw another firefighter being placed in a medic unit to be checked out. He appeared to be priority three, which means non-life threatening. I don't know about the first one that was transported. I heard reports that a total of three firefighters were injured. They actually had a rescue call come out. The firefighters actually said over the radio a mayday call, and the fire department was very quick to jump into action to rescue those individuals because this fire was just so unpredictable. We have video to show you of what it looked like when the fire department first responded to the scene here. They had a total of 3 to 4 homes that were fully engulfed in flames, and it was rapidly expanding. Now, we understand the fifth house at this location only has a little bit of damage to the roof, but fire crews were able to extinguish that. Now, right now, the fire is not under control. It is contained, but not under control. They have requested BGE to respond to deal with the electrical arcing in the area because there's so many power lines. West Belvedere Avenue is shut down both east and west, just to the east of Reisterstown Road. And Reisterstown Road at Belvedere going northbound is shut down in both directions. We still don't have a cause here on the fire. We're still trying to get more information. As we do, we will update you. Reporting live at Sky Team 11, I'm Captain Roy Taylor.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you all for being here tonight. Of course, of interest to everyone is the second alarm fire that occurred this afternoon and injuries that many of our members suffered while involved in battling that fire. Tonight, we have before us Mayor Brandon Scott. We have Fire Chief James Wallace. We have Chief Administrative Officer Faith Leach. We have our two of our firefighters, local president Matt Coster. We have our fire officers president Josh Fannin. We also have acting deputy police commissioner Kevin Jones. We also have the support of our colleagues in the fire service from the surrounding counties, Anne Arundel County, Baltimore County, Carroll County. We also have Howard County, Frederick County. So what I'm going to do is have Fire Chief Wallace come forward, share brief remarks, followed by Mayor Brandon Scott.
Good evening. At approximately 3:45 p.m. today, fire units responded to the 5200 block of Linden Heights Avenue for a report of a fire. Upon arrival on location, companies were met with extensive fire and smoke conditions. Shortly after firefighters gained entry to perform attack on the fire appeared to rapidly grow in intensity. As a result, the incident commander requested a second alarm, bringing additional manpower and resources to the scene. While battling the fire, five firefighters suffered injuries, and tonight it is with a heavy heart that I must announce one member has tragically perished as a result of his injuries. The four other firefighters suffered varying degrees of burns and are being treated at area hospitals. The cause of this fire remains under investigation. I want to extend my love and my prayers to the families and victims of this tragic event, as well as to the members of the Baltimore City Fire Department. We want them to know that we keep them in their prayers and will continue to do so throughout this event. Thank you.
Baltimore lost a hero, one of our bravest and most dedicated public servants, and have four others that are injured. Each and every one of these firefighters put themselves in harm's way and put all of our lives in Baltimore before theirs each and every day. And tragically, tonight, one of them gave their life for our city, for us to be safer. We will continue and will investigate this fully. But tonight, really Baltimore's focus should be on supporting of these families, supporting this department, and supporting really the city, as we have to wrap our arms around them as they are dealing with tragic loss in their family and dealing with injury in their family of people who dedicate themselves to protecting others over themselves. This is what we have to do in this moment, and this is what we're asking everyone to do as we find out what happened here, but knowing that a hero lost their life tonight by putting Baltimore first. And I'll turn it over to Council President Mosby.
Firefighters are our living superheroes. We don't expect to lose them. Tonight is a tragic night for all citizens here in the great city of Baltimore. But it's a reminder of what firefighters do on a regular basis to protect and serve our city, ensure that each one of us are safe. When they leave their homes and they say goodbye to their families, they know that they might be met with something that might not bring them back to their families. And unfortunately, that is what the city is grappling with tonight. We stand with all the men and women of the Baltimore City Fire Department. We understand the agony, we understand the loss, and we'll continue to support the mayor, the administration, the fire department, as best as the council can. It's a really sad night for all of us. It's a hard night, but it's even a harder night for that firefighter's family. Looking in their eyes is unbelievable. So again, they are living superheroes. It's important that we respect them, we uplift them, and we support them as much as possible.
The city like a siren song, wailing over the rooftops the whole night long. Saw a shooting star like a diamond in the sky. Must be someone's soul passing by. These are the streets where we used to run, where your papa's from. These are the days where you become what you become. These are the streets where the story's told, the truth unfolds, and darkness settles in. Oh, shine your light down on me. Lift me up so I can see. Shine your light when you're gone. Give me the strength to carry on, carry on. Shine your light when you're gone. Give me the strength. Saw him walking by the side of the road, maybe trying to find his way home. He's here but not here, he's gone but not gone. Just hope he knows if I get lost.